We are here with Rob Bone, who is president of Amilco USA. And one of the great things about this conference, Rob, is we not only get to talk to the IGTs and the G-Techs or the Cygames of the world that a lot of people know, but we get a chance to introduce some of the newer, smaller players and who are going to play a role in this industry as it develops, and Amilco is one of them. So tell us a little bit about who Amilco is.
Well, first, Frank, thanks for the opportunity. And I think you're spot on. I think there's lots of organizations that are coming to take advantage of sports wagering. And it doesn't necessarily have to be the big guys that we normally know. Amilco is arguably the best unknown brand in sports wagering. And I say that because our presence is fairly decent, but again, the market doesn't know about us. We provide all of the sportsbook operations for the Stars Group, or BetStars. So we're launched and operational in New Jersey. And via the market access deal that the Stars Group did with El Dorado, we'll have the opportunity to go into as many as 13 other states. And that's solely just with our partnership with the Stars Group. Separate from that, we're aggressively looking at different commercial agreements across the country in states that have already legislated, are going to legislate, or are down the road substantially. So we're looking at all different avenues. I mean, you won't see the Amilco name in big bright lights on sponsorships and, you know, with big booths at some of these events, but very credible organization, very, you know, egoless organization. And I would say we're coming to the market, eyes wide open, ears wide open, listening to the customers in terms of how we can modify our product to be successful.
And what specifically is that product?
Great question. So when looking at a sportsbook platform, I think you have to look at it in a couple different ways from an omni-channel perspective. First and foremost is what's necessary from a technology standpoint to take a bet across a counter. So you have a retail teller of sorts that will allow a human or, you know, basically an attendant to interact with the guest, process a bet, hand them a ticket, and effectively allow them to also redeem it. So we call that retail sportsbook. Then you have a kiosk or a self-service betting terminal integrated with a sportsbook platform where the player can walk up to it, basically scroll through the various options that they have, select their bet, insert the cash in, get a ticket, and it's a self-serve betting terminal. So it allows them to go up and consume what bet they want at their discretion. Then naturally, the most exciting is the online or mobile. And this is where a lot of the technology gets interesting in terms of profiling the player, presenting them with relevant content, but more importantly, as we all know, the convenience of allowing people to access a sportsbook in the palm of their hands, in the convenience of their home. So, you know, omni-channel sportsbook platform is inclusive of all that hardware and software, but it ultimately comes down to pricing, you know, the opportunity for a platform to exist in different channels, and we're the technology that the operators would have to utilize to get into that market.
So when you have a deal like El Dorado, mm-hmm. where you have the Stars Group, and then you have William Hill, you're able to serve that environment because you're providing the technology.
Absolutely. I mean, and it's not known either. So when the Stars Group goes and partners with El Dorado and they have the opportunity to be a second skin or an online offering for them, quietly, we're powering them to do that. And there's some, you know, small elements as to what they do from a proprietary standpoint to make it theirs, but ultimately it's foundationally our technology and we're leveraging that market access to do the same things with other people outside of El Dorado.
There's a lot of competition out there.
There is.
And some of it comes from some really big guys and some of it comes from some small guys who all have a story. What is your competitive advantage?
I think it's mindset, Frank. 100%. I think it's about, you know, realizing there are a lot of capable thought leaders that operate sportsbooks in Nevada, in New Jersey, or wherever current operations exist. And instead of what I call plug and play from the UK, just taking your sportsbook and offering it in the same way that it is operating in Europe or in the UK, we're looking at putting it through an Americanized filter. We're talking with various people to make sure that our trading screens, our bet entry screens, all of the pieces, the features and functionality of our platform are Americanized. And I think that's an important concept. So we really are, you know, egoless, and we have a great sense of humility of coming to the market saying, tell us what we need to do to make our product as Americanized and as simplistic as possible. Because we have to keep in mind, the people running sportsbook operations have been using systems for a long time. Bringing something in that is very different and somewhat complex for them to adjust to, I think it's a challenging prospect. So all we have to do is listen and modify our product accordingly.
You talk about being Americanized, and you are an American.
And how'd you know?
One of the things, the accent gave you away immediately. And one of the things that I think we've all seen, is that a lot of these guys come over from the UK and Sweden and other places, and they've got a lot of experience behind themselves, and they come to this big gold rush from the United States, and all of a sudden they run into this you know, crazy quilt of legislation and regulation. It's not, you know, one national government setting a policy, and we all know what's going to happen. Tribal jurisdictions and so on. How do you see the development of sports betting rolling out here in the U.S. over the next several years?
Well, one, I think you hit a very big component, which is empathy for the governance and the compliance aspects. I think any company coming over from the U.K. or from any country over in Europe, if they told you that they were not surprised about how complex it is, they'd be fooling you. I think we're much more rigorous, we're much more judicious in how we approach the compliance process. Nevada, GLI, you know, New Jersey, Mississippi, all the jurisdictions that you're familiar with, those of us that have been in the market and understand it, we empathize and we know how to navigate through it. The people coming over, I think, have to go through, unfortunately, a painful process to learn that. In terms of it rolling out, I think it's going to be, you know, in some states, very fast. I've seen states that typically don't necessarily move very quickly, put bills together, get them on the governor's desk, and put themselves in a situation to, you know, honestly open up sports books before the NFL season this year. Contrastly, you have other states that, you know, are going to go a little bit more slow and deliberately, and that's okay. Ultimately, those that are first to market, though, are going to have a really big competitive advantage. And I think there's some states that aren't necessarily known as being tip of the spear in embracing gambling, embracing sportsbook, embracing these kind of experiences that are going to move quickly.
Now, you're a privately owned company.
Correct.
Can you tell us a little bit about the ownership?
Absolutely, absolutely. And it's a differentiating element, too. So the Amelco USA IBU is basically a 50-50 joint venture between Damian Walton, who's the owner of the Amelco UK parent, and Rob Miller. Rob Miller has operated in the US space for years and years, has done over $1 billion worth of investment in the gaming space, was originally with Sierra Design Group, helped form Gaming Capital Group that functions out of Oklahoma, and his Native American relationships and just his relationships across the industry really open up a lot of opportunity for us to discuss potential opportunities with people across the US. So the formation of it between Damian and Rob, I think just sets a great tone and culture for how we function, but it also, from a networking standpoint, gives us a lot of opportunity to discuss business with people across the country.
When you say Native American, I assume that's part of your opportunity.
100%. I mean, you look at different tribes that are looking to legislate and take advantage of bills that are being passed, and I'll give you a case in point. In New Mexico, Santa Ana Star. I mean, all they did is basically look at their compact and say, we feel that, you know, sports betting is included in our compact. We're going to move forward, and the governor agreed. And next thing you know, they're opening a retail sports book. There are other states and other tribes within those states that are functioning the same way, meaning as soon as that bill is approved, they don't have to wait for the state-issued rules and regulations. They can go right away and launch. And we're talking with multiple casino customers, tribal casino customers, that are trying to take advantage of that. And I think that first to market mentality is going to pay off for them.
Anything else folks should know about Amelco?
You know, I think that the big takeaway is, we're not a well-known brand. I think the awareness of the Amelco USA name is not necessarily there today, but you know, we're here to partner, and we're here to really seek very, very collaborative partnerships with sportsbook operators across the country. We may not be the most well-known brand, but you know, I think our capabilities and our features and functionality are very notable, and encourage you guys to seek us out so that we can prove it to you.
Rob, great overview. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Frank. Appreciate it.